Hi guys, welcome back to another Cut Above with Chris, and I'm moving on to my head shave now. I've just finished off my face with a Mueller R41 with an Asco blade. Just popped some Shave Works, a Cool Fix on, feels great. And I'm just going to pop this blade out. I'll be back in a second, I'm just going to pop another blade in. And we're back. So, Mueller R41. I've just popped a brand new Asco blade in there. Love this blade. Really, do you know something? I would say it's my favourite blade now. Over the Bascot. Really, really top-notch blade. Really sharp. Smooth. Really, really smooth. For me, anyway. And to use it on my face with a Mueller R41, and all I've ended up with is a couple, well, just one actually. Tiny little nick there, and it's tiny. For a whole face shave, three passes, super smooth, it's incredible, just with three passes. I didn't even need a pick up really. I just finished my third pass and it finished off beautifully. So I'm going to pop on my head shave now. For you guys that watch the face shave, you already know this, but I've popped some of this on here. Edwin Jagger pre-hydrating pre-shave lotion, which is great stuff. I've still got the menthol cooling effect on my head. You can actually still see some of it on the side here. But it hasn't quite dried in yet, which is good, keeps the hair moist, a bit of moisture in there. I'm using Edwin Jagger Cooling Menthol Shaving Cream, which I have already pre-lathered in the bowl for my face shave. There's not much left in here, but I think I'm going to have enough to finish off my head shave. This will be the sort of test of it, using the badger brush instead of using the small. I will do this exact same shave, same shaving cream, same everything, with the Simog 830, just to test whether it is such a thirsty brush that it makes it difficult to get a full good lathered shave out of it. So I'm just going to wet my head and start off with the front part. Not that there's much hair there. I just find it seems to dry out real fast if you do your whole head in one go. As you can see, it's got a good lather on there. I do find with the Edwin Jagger pre-shave and also the Proraso that it doesn't really affect your lather at all, which is good. I hear about a lot of products out there that actually affect the quality of your lather. Alright, so let's get stuck in. Mueller R41, just warmed the blade up with the Asco. I'll just tilt this camera up just a touch, because I'm not doing my face anymore, and hopefully we'll get a better view there with the grain. And once again, I cannot say it enough how smooth this blade is. I mean, that's super, super smooth. It's not a blade that, I'll be honest with you, that I see a lot of people use. I don't see it, it never seems to crop up on YouTube much. I did a bit of a search on it, I couldn't find much on it, people using it. I don't know if it's because they're new out or it was just people just trying them before and they were rubbish. Maybe they've updated them, I don't know. But in my opinion, it's definitely up there. It's got the smoothness of a Vascot or an Astra SP, it's got that smoothness. You also get the sharpness of, probably not quite a feather, but it's not far off a feather, if I'm honest. It's very, very similar shave to what I got from the feather blade. Which is another blade that I really enjoy using, which I've actually ran out of. Now, I was actually going to order some more so that I could do my head. However, this razor has really moved the goalposts in terms of my outlook on what I want from a razor blade. It's sharp, smooth, what more can you possibly want? I mean, another test would be to see how long it lasts. But I paid about £4.50 for 200 of those blades. And if all 200 of them shave like this, that will be the bargain of the century in my eyes. Doing something like shaving. Alright, let's see if I can do this again. So I don't know what the lather's like there, guys, on the back of my head, but yeah, as you can see, there's a lot more on there. I don't remember there being quite as much when I did my last head shave. It was some milk. It was definitely some there, obviously, but... my hair wasn't very long when I started this shave. So... I'm expecting this shave to be a little bit faster. Yeah, I mean, there's definitely a good bit of lather still on my head there. Catching all that hair. And no, guys, I'm not doing this in fast motion on the computer. It's not in fast forward. I really am that fast. Nothing like being a bit cocky before you slice your head open. Just kissing one of the kids night night there. That's one down, two to go. Pass number two. Let's see what the lather's like. I've left a bit of water on my head here. I should really have got rid of it. There's loads of lather here. I'm just going to do my whole head here because I think this is going to be a quick shave. Those famous last words, quick shave. Yeah, right. Well, I wanted to be quick. Really enjoy my shaving there, which is a surprise. Now for those of you guys out there that have never done this with your hair before, you haven't used a double-edged razor, obviously if you watch my channel I haven't used an open razor yet, or a cutthroat as it's sometimes referred to. It really is a lot easier. I used to use a big razor on my head, believe it or not. With the big razor, I used to always come away with nicks and razor rash, no matter what, because all I did for that whole time shaving with that razor was go over the same parts over and over and over again. And I've got a little nick there, just on the side of my head, just a little tiny one, just right there. I don't know if that was that spot I had before. I don't think it was. I think I've just... that's a new one, I think. Pretty sure that's new. And for those of you that can hear that shouting in the background, that is my lovely 11-year-old daughter giving it heave-ho with her mum. One of the other joys of shaving. You can just sit back and relax. Right, now this was the test which I struggled with other blades in this razor with the Judd ring. Well, let's see how we go. No, that's pretty good to me. Now you can see I can pull that blade all the way up there. Obviously the difficulty with shaving the back of your head is you don't know whether you're taking chunks of skin. So I'm sure all you guys back home, if I am, will be having a bit of a laugh at my expense. Right. Yeah, got a tiny little nick there. Nothing major. So, I mean, so as you can see, this is using my badger brush. I've still got tons of lather. Literally, probably enough for another 3 passes on my head. Easily. Just gonna get my head. Just a quick little rinse around. There's not much left on there. When it comes to my head, I don't like leaving anything now. Sorry guys, I'm just sort of concentrating, trying to find all the last bits here. I'm not ignoring you. That's incredible, isn't it? Look at that. Look at that, guys. Really, what is that all about? What an amazing lather. And this is just a sort of run-of-the-mill. Nothing special about me lather. It's just high mass, but just without showing too much disrespect to Edmund Jagger, but it is crap compared to your artisan, so. I'm really looking forward to actually giving this big bowl of bash with some of my artisan soaps and really whipping up a good thick lather with it. Because there's just no doubt about it, the artisans have got it right. Maybe not all of them, but So the ones I've got here, your Wickhams, Shave of Heaven, I've really cracked down on the formula and got it right. It does make for a lovely shave. Right guys, there's nothing left on my head, I can assure you. I normally always find one or two straggling hairs run about my ear once I'm finished, and I've actually completely finished. Other than that, quite happy with that. And look at the amount of lather I've got left there. My bowl still heaps in there from that tiny little spot of shaving cream. So it's really, really impressive stuff. Just really happy with it. Absolute mess when I do mine. Oh, lovely stuff. Oh. And there we have it, guys. Another close shave. There's a bite there. Shouldn't really be anything there. Might have a few nicks or something, but obviously I can't see them. The only thing I've got is literally a tiny, tiny spot right there. Which, if you just give me a second, I'll be back in a second. Keep cutting in out of this one. Alum block or alum stick. Picked up from the local pharmacy. Deonat. It's actually a deodorant stick. Same stuff. Little pop on there. Dry off the alum block, put the lid on, and as you can see, that's pretty much gone now. Nothing happening. Okay, so I'm going to finish off with Shave What's Cool Fix again. I'll just pop that up a bit slow, that was a little bit fast. That's all you need. If you feel any pain, it will let you know. Finish off today with a new one that I've only used it once on video, I think. Really, really enjoy it. It's almost got like a slickness to it. It's like really moisturising. Nivea Originals Aftershave Splash. It's got a lovely scent as well. Really mild. So a lovely fresh, it's like a soapy fresh scent. It smells great though. I don't mind going a bit overboard with this stuff. And I just slap it everywhere. There we have it, guys. Another successful head shave. Mueller R41. Asco blade. Brilliant blades. Get yourself some. They're really cheap. Really cheap. They're that cheap that I'll send you a packet if you want a packet. No issues at all. Started off with the Edwin Jagger on my head. Pre-shave lotion. Hydrating lotion and menthol. Really nice. Got a lovely menthol feeling to it. Does not mess with your lather at all. I've used it with Purasso and I've used it with Edwin Jagger now. It does not mess with your lather. So don't worry about it screwing your lather up. It will not do that. I then finished off with my Allen block and my little nick. Shave Works a Cool Fix. Best stuff on the market as far as I'm concerned. I've got a few things. This stuff works a treat. And then good old trusty Nivea Men Originals, which I love. Leave your skin feeling soft. So thanks again for tuning in, guys. Thanks for coming along and enjoying the video, hopefully. New subscribers, thank you for subscribing. If you're new to the channel, you've never subscribed, please click the link below and subscribe to the channel. And I'll catch you guys next time.